A certain prophet named Agabus came down from Judea, and coming to us, Luke reports, he took Paul's belt and he bound it at his feet and hands and said, this is what the Holy Spirit says. In this way, the Jews of Jerusalem will bind the man who owns this belt and deliver him into the hands of the Gentiles. When his friends began crying out this news, Paul said, what are you doing weeping and breaking my heart? For I am ready not only to be bound, but even to die at Jerusalem for the sake of the name of Jesus Christ. Acts chapter 21, verse 13. Paul had no fear of those who could only kill the body. He had already said, but I do not consider my life of any account as dear to myself, so that I may finish my course in the ministry which I received from the Lord Jesus Christ, to testify solemnly of the gospel of the grace of God, in Acts chapter 20, verse 24. People, however, even Satan himself, are unable to kill the soul. Physical death is the full extent of the watchness of the harm that can be brought to us. They cannot touch our soul, the eternal person. Even the bodies they destroyed will one day be resurrected and become imperishable. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 42. I'm telling you, you have the victory throughout this whole life. Even though somebody may kill us, we might, you know, get assassinated, we might be martyred for Christ, whatever the case may be, they still cannot destroy our soul.
Amen.
They cannot destroy our soul. And even if they kill this body, guess what? One day, you're going to be resurrected.
That's right.
And you're going to probably, I think we're going to look just like we do right now.
Coming back.
We're going to have a name, a new name written on our forehead. And we're going to have our name written in the Lamb's Book of Life. But I believe just like Jesus came back, I believe we're going to look just like we do right now. We're just going to be resurrected. We're going to have new bodies that won't die.
Hallelujah.
That won't feel no pain, no emotions. We won't get sick. We won't ever die. We can't catch no diseases. We won't have sin. None of that will be on us. I believe we'll look like this, because when Jesus resurrected and he came back, he looked just like he did when they crucified, before they crucified him, before they messed him up. He came back looking just like he did. And I believe we're going to come back looking just like we do right now. All right, y'all. I'm hastening. I see y'all. Y'all getting weary now. Look, don't get weary in your well-doing. It should be made clear that destroy does not here mean annihilation. The last or the lost will not cease to exist, only judgment remains. But in the resurrection body, we will go, the wicked will go into eternal fire and punishment, just as the saved, when their resurrected bodies, will go into eternal life. Matthew 25, 46. Jesus' point here is that the only fear a believer should have is of him who is able to destroy both soul and body and put it in hell. And only God can do that. In the last days, Satan himself will be cast into hell, which is the Lord's domain. It is his real estate, not Satan's. That is what Satan, listen, it is in Matthew's gospel that the Lord made hell for Satan and his angels. It's nowhere in the Bible that says God made hell for man.
Nope.
Nowhere. If you can find it and show it to me. I've been reading the Bible for almost 25 years. Show it to me. I've been back and forth looking for it. Show it to me if you can find it. But it clearly states in the gospels that God made hell for Satan and his angels.
Amen.
Now, watch this. Those who reject the good news, who reject the gospel, guess what? They're going in there with them. I'll wait for their ears right now. Those that don't accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and you don't make your peace with God, you are in enmity with him. You are his enemy. Yet while we was his enemies, he demonstrated his love to us. You are his enemy. If you don't know him in the part of your sins, you are his enemy. You are his enemy. If you don't know him, I'd rather be a child of the king than be an orphan on my way to hell.
My God.
I wait for the amen to God. Amen. I said, those people that reject the good news, they're going to be orphans, because if you're a child of the king, you ain't got nothing to worry about. I'm preaching now. I'm preaching the good news now. If you're a child, if you're a son or a daughter of the Most High God, you ain't got nothing to worry about. Your name is already written in the Lamb's book of life. You're going to have a new body.
Nobody.
And something happened. This
that's right.
I ain't worried about what's happening with this one.
Yeah.
I'm going to actually be cremated.
Right now.
Yeah, I already got it. It's already in the plan. I'm going to be cremated. Because why? This is going back to the dust one way or another. And what I want is my ashes thrown over the Atlantic Ocean, because I've traveled all my life. I might as well let my ashes travel, because this body will no longer be mine. I'll wait for the amen to die down. And it ain't nowhere in the Bible that talks about cremation. There's nowhere in the scriptures that talk about whether you can be cremated or not, because guess what? You're going back to ashes one way or the other. The other way just takes you longer, and it's actually kind of stupid, because you spend a whole bunch of money. I wish I had some praying people in here. I know y'all want to remember people, and I know you want to put them in the ground, right, and all that kind of stuff, but you can save yourself a whole lot of money if you just do it the way I'm cremating myself.
Amen.
I'm going to set myself on fire.
Amen.
I ain't going to be here. No, I'm just playing. I'm going to be cremated. Y'all, I'm going to be cremated for real. That's what I want. That's my wishes. Because I don't want nobody to spend $6,000-$7,000 to put a coffin in there. It's going to take a while for your body to decompose. And the worm's going to eat it up. The Bible talks about it in Revelation. The worm going to eat your body up. So I'd rather just go ahead on and cremate me. Take my ashes and throw them in the Atlantic Ocean. And that's going to save a lot of money. Because you still got to live after I'm done. I'll wait for the next man. That's my wish. As believers, our eternal destiny is heaven. God's ability to destroy both soul and body in hell is mentioned here only to contrast his unlimited and permanent power against Satan's limited and temporary power. God is the only one who can determine and bring to pass the destiny of souls and bodies. Revenge of God in his sovereign majesty is a powerful motivation for Christians to serve him and to be fearless of any earthly physical consequences that service may bring. The power of human, watch this, the power of human threats seem rather puny in comparison to the power of God's promises. When Latimer was preaching one day in the presence of King Henry VIII. He reports that he said to himself, "Latimer, Latimer." And then he said, "Remember that the king is here. Be careful what you say." Then he said to himself, "Latimer, Latimer. Remember the King of Kings is here. Be careful of what you do not say."
That's right.
For such unflinching faithfulness, Latimer was eventually burned at the stake. But he feared failing God more than he feared offending man.
Well,
y'all better get this. Mm-hmm. Turning away from Jesus is not rejecting a religion. Turning away from Jesus Christ is much more than rejecting historical, traditional Christianity. Turning away from Jesus Christ is turning away from the living God. It is turning away from life himself.
Yep.
Only the judgment remains. The Hebrew writer said these words, and I'm going to close with this. He says that everything is laid bare and naked before the true and living God.
That's right.
Hebrews chapter 4, verse 13. I don't know about you today.
That's right.
But the judgment remains.
Only the judgment remains. That's right.
And this is not something to make you fearful. This is something to make you think. That if you have not made your peace with God, this day, July the 10th, 2016. You need to make your peace with him, because
amen.
He just spoke a warning to you.
Amen.
You might say, Pastor Willie, you just sit down and put that together. I'm not that intelligent. I'm not that smart. Pastor Willie, you've been in seminary for at least a year. That don't make no difference. That came straight from the throne.
Amen.
That came straight from the throne.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. If you don't know him in the part of your sins, this warning is for you. concerning all this stuff that's taking place in this world and in this United States and all around us. Black lives matter, blue lives matter. Everybody lies about it. God is hurting just as bad as those people that have lost their loved ones. His heart is broken and he's grieved too because of the fact. And we grieve him. We grieve him on a daily basis. We grieve him when we just disobey him, as if he don't know our future, as if he don't know what's planned ahead for us. You know, it grieves him when we won't obey him and just listen to him and just walk in the order that he's called us in every day. He grieves him. So don't just think that he's grieved because we've had all this loss of life. Look at all the many lives that have been lost down through the centuries. The senseless, the natives, the Indians, our ancestors from Africa, all sorts of people. You know, there's all sorts of wars going on right now that you don't even know nothing about. They said Obama, there was a report a couple of weeks ago put out, said Obama got seven wars going on right now. He got seven wars going on right now. We don't hear about that stuff, Fish, because you know we don't hear about everything, and then the government gonna lie to us anyway. It's smoke and mirror. Everything we basically see on television is subliminal. It's to have you think in a certain way. You know? That's why people advertise stuff. Come on in, we got a deal for you. Then when you get there, it ain't no deal. But they got you in the store. So now you might look at something else.
Yeah.
You gonna buy something before you leave from there. Like,
well, I'm already at the store. I'm not just paying.
Buy something. Use a ball.
I don't care nothing about that mess when they advertise. It's smoke and mirrors. But this ain't. This is not smoke and mirrors. This is the truth. This is Jesus himself speaking. Y'all heard that piece, and I'm getting ready to close, but did y'all hear that piece when he says, I did not come to bring peace?
This
is word. You know why? Because he wants your attention. He wants a personal relationship with you, and if you don't have it with him, guess what? I'll say it again, you are his enemy. I know y'all saying, Pastor, that's hard, man. You come to drunk. What?
That's true.
Probably that's why y'all don't want anybody to come here. I got to tell the truth, because your blood ain't going to be on mine.
Amen.
Yeah, that's right.
Uh-huh. I got to preach the whole council. I got to tell it like it is, because if I don't do what he called me to do, when I face him, see, I'm going to be accountable.
That's right.
The first thing he going to tell me is, I didn't tell him what I said. Like, it was simple. I gave you the courage and the boldness to do it, but you changed the whole message around and say what you want to say. I ain't going out like that saying. I know the importance of being pardoned of my sins. I know the stuff I did. My grandbabies, I'm glad they didn't know me back then. Look at an example of what I did, but I'm here. Thank God. I'm here tonight. I know the seriousness of knowing him personally, and it is rich when you come to know him personally. It takes a lot of depression, stress, anxiety off of worration. It takes all that mess off of you when you put it on him and give it to him, because he's God. He's the only one that can handle it. He's the only one that can fix it. And so, if you don't know him to pardon your sins, you can stay in there. You need to make your peace with him, because only judgment remains. You see, everything has taken place. Jesus has come on the earth. He lived for 33 years. He did 3 years of ministry. He obeyed God even unto the cross, even unto death. He obeyed. All right. Got up from the grave after 3 days being there, and he went back to God. All right. So guess what, y'all? Ain't nothing else got to happen but him coming back.
Amen.
I mean, all prophecy has been fulfilled. Now, this stuff we wait for in Revelations, that's the tribulation period. Guess what? You know, I ain't waiting for the tribulation.
No.
I'm waiting for the here and now. Today is the day of salvation. You know, today is today. You know, he might call my name on the road today. And guess what? If he do, I'll be just like that thief on the cross. Remember me. Yeah. And you enter into your paradise.
Yes.
Yeah. Sir, I might not have crossed every T and dotted every I, but Lord, I love you.
Yes.
That's how I'm serving.
Yes.
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 I'm going to go on in with you now.
Yeah, Lord.
And try to go to hell and burn for eternity, because that's just as eternal as you're going to be in heaven.
Yes, sir.
Gonna burn forever. But if you don't know the Lord and pardon your sin, you need to bow your head, close your eyes. There should be nobody watching but me. If you don't know him and pardon your sin, should nobody be watching but me. Bow your head, close your eyes. Just hold your hand up and acknowledge him, because he said if you don't acknowledge him, he said that he's going to disown you. Hold your hand up. Everybody should be bowed, eyes closed. I should be the only one that's looking. Because he wants to save you. He wants a personal relationship with you. He wants to be your friend. That's what he's called in the scriptures. He's called our friend, not just our Savior and our Lord and Master, but he wants to save you this morning. All right, repeat after me, Father in heaven.
Amen.
Come on, repeat after me. Lord, forgive me.
Lord, forgive me.
I repent of my sins.
I repent of my sins.
I disobeyed you.
Somehow.
And I'm asking you, please forgive me.
And
I want to turn from my will.
I
want to turn from my way. And I want to turn to you. That's what repentance is. I want my mind changed. Come on, follow me. I want my heart changed. I want you to transform me. I want you to come in my heart. And I want you to live in me. And I thank you for your Son. Jesus Christ. Who died on the cross. For my sins. Who got up after 3 days. With all power and
authority.
In his hand. Thank you. Jesus.
Thank you for Jesus.
Thank you for the Holy Spirit.
Thank you for the Holy Spirit.
I love you, Father.
I love you, Father.
And Jesus.
And Jesus, man.
Everybody who loves him and agrees, say amen.
Amen.
Your hands for the Lord. Amen. Your hands. If you made that pledge of allegiance, if you pledge your allegiance to him, I can tell you right now, you're saved, you're born again, and you're in a Bible believing church.
Exactly.
You don't have no business here today, because that's what I